Hello, welcome to Blender TC. In today's tutorial, I'm just going to answer this question that I saw on blenderartist.org, and it's how to place an image on a curved object. It says, hey guys, is any possible image on a curved object? Like the example picture, and he'd like this done on white. So what I've done is actually created an image in white, on white, and we'll be using that image to produce the bottle. The bottle that we're going to do is this Blender Magic Beans, and just for good measure I've put some brown plastic and a white cap on it. Please subscribe. Let's begin. First of all, I'm going to delete the cube, so X to delete. Right, I've deleted the cube. Now what I'm going to add is I'm going to add a mesh, and the mesh is going to be a cylinder. I'm going to alter this cylinder so it's got 64 faces, because I just think it gives a better effect when you're doing a glass or something like that. Gives it much smoother, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to smooth shade that. Scale that up in the Z direction to make it more can shaped, and G and Z to move it up. And what we've got now is we've got a cylinder. Just hit the actual tab key to go into edit mode there. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to subdivide this and take it up to the top, take one down to the bottom. This just improves the look of the thing. Right, so now we've got a cylinder. So the first thing we want to do is actually put an image on the cylinder. The easiest way and one of the best ways I've found of doing this is to actually take your cylinder and then cut it up into different pieces. So I'm going to control on R. Select the edge in edit mode, control on R, and I'm going to put the label somewhere in the center of the actual jar here. So in fact, now I'll do it slightly towards the bottom, but GG to move it down and GG to move it down. One of the simplest methods I've found is that what we do is I've pre-made the actual graphic. So I'm going to add the actual object to the add the label to this cylinder. So I'm going to go into this here and I'm going to create a new material. This is the actual material properties, put new, and then I've got a pre-selected image, so I'm just going to, at the base colour, you hit the little dot at the side of it, and then you hit image texture. Select that, there, which is the little folder icon, and I've put this in the magic bean. And as you can see, if you can see it at all, see if we can go to a larger icon. What we've got there, it says Blender Magic Beans, so I'm just going to open that up. The other thing I'm going to do is put my setting to Eevee, just to make things appear more easily. And then what I've done, as you can see, the image is totally in the wrong place, and this is a problem that a lot of people face. So next what we do is, looking from the front by pressing the 1 key, I'll go into edit mode and I'm going to add some I'm going to mark some seams. So what I've done there is press the Alt key down, left mouse click, and then I'm going to mark the seam there. That then cuts that shape out. I'm going to cut the actual seam on the bottom out there on the bottom, and then mark seam again. And then what I'm going to do is select this edge by pressing the Alt key and selecting the edge. What you've got is you've got edge, face select and point select. But I'm just going to select that one edge, pressing the Alt key and then selecting it again, selects the whole thing, and then mark seam again. Now what we've got there is we've got three seams. Right, so that's what that's going to do is that's going to appear like a flat piece of paper. That's going to appear like a round piece of paper, and that's going to appear like a round piece of paper. And then the next thing we need to do simply is A, select all, press the U key, and then just unwrap by pressing the unwrap. As you can see, what we've got there now doesn't seem to have altered at all, which it hasn't yet. So what we do is we go into UV editing. See, we're still in edit mode, so we've got into UV editing and we've got the actual picture there of my label that I want to put around the actual object. And here we've got the actual top and the bottom. So select any point by selecting the point up here, select the point, press the L key, and that grabs the whole face. So if I press G now, I can move that anywhere I want, or shrink it down, or do anything. And this is going to be the top. If you put a graphic in there, that'd appear on the top face, and same on this one. Select any point, press the L key and G, and as you can see, I'm going to scale it down by pressing the S key and just move it to somewhere out the way. And then what we've got now is we've got, select any other point, press the L key, rotate by 90, and then we can just move that G over to there. I want the label to actually appear where I've put them two lines, and as you can see, that looks like it's upside down, which it is. So I'm going to rotate, press R key, 180, just like a circle. It's 360 degrees, so 180, we'll flip them round. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to scale that in the Y direction to make the label drop between the two lines there. So G, scale it in the Y direction by S and Y, and G and Z. And then I'm just going to scale it in the X direction just to shrink it slightly. Just so. And there we have it. So then if we go back out of edit mode, and if I just take this over to the end and go into the actual thing, as you can see, we've got the label now in place and the white background. Now I hear you saying that that's very well and everything, but it doesn't look like much. But if we were to make, say, this face here glass, or green glass or something, and make the top into the actual shape of the bottle, which we can do quite easily now by going to the modelling area. Go into modelling, press the tab key. What I'm going to do is select this edge here, press GG key just to move it beyond the edge. And you see this is going on thing, so press Alt key, GG, must move it past the edge. I know it's not exactly Z ideal, but in fact what I'll do is I'll leave that for a minute. I'll alter this round later on. I'll just get onto the actual point of the putting different materials on there. So now we've got a label, but say we wanted to make this into an actual green glass, the actual top and bottom that's not actually on the label. What we could do very simply is we go into the actual materials management properties, add another property. Oh, sorry, done that wrong. Add another property, so select thingy, select new it here. We'll call this one label anyway, just to so we don't get confused. And I'm going to add another material, and I'm going to call this, oh, pardon me, new material, green glass. So select a green colour you like by selecting on the colour. I think that's about right. Make it a bit darker to look like old green glass. Or you could have brown glass, depending on what, if you want it to be like a pharmaceutical bottle. And to make it into a glass, make it quite shiny. Give it a bit of alpha transmission. And then I'm going to select alpha blend, alpha clip. And the other thing that I'm going to do is take the alpha down to make it see-through. And as you can see, it has no effect on the model because we've not added this new colour, the green. I'll change it to brown glass now. Brown. Do that by double clicking on there. You can also do it by changing the noise by pressing F2 if you wish. So that's selected on the cylinder, but if I were on the glass and then pressed F2, sorry, press the, no, it's not working at all today. Anyway, that there is the cylinder. Double click on there allows you to change its name. So I'm going to go back into edit mode, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to Control R, move that round there, and I'm going to add a third colour to this, and this is just going to be standard white, so new. And that can be the top of my bottle. So select face select, press the Alt key down, select those edges, select the bottom, select those edges, and then any other edges that you wish to be glass. You just press the Shift key down, Shift, 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 Shift. As you can see, that's going to overlap on the glass, but you get the idea. Right, in fact, I'm going to move that edge. Control C. So we've got all those edges. In fact, that's gone too far. So I'm going to select that edge there. Select that edge there, there, there. Anything that you want to be glass, you actually select it. So press the Shift key down. No, it's not ideal, this, because I've just slightly messed it up. And then what we're going to do, select the brown glass, assign the brown glass, and if we go into edit mode, as you can see, the alpha is a bit too thingy, but take the alpha down, and then we've got a see-through glass. If you add a bit of thickness to that, select that base face now, because that needs to be glass as well. Select the brown glass, assign it to that face. So now what we've got a brown glass, and we've got a plastic lid up there. If I were to select the actual lid there, and then go and select, check a deselect, and scale it up, so E, and then scale, and we'll just get the actual, a rough idea of a, Control R, let's do that, and this is just quick modelling, so it's not by no means perfect, but you get the idea. So now we've got a jar with a lid on it saying Blender Magic Beans, and all we're going to do here is I'm just going to add a bit of thickness to it, so add the modifier, solidify, make the glass 0.3, just gives a bit of thickness to it and makes it look more like a plastic glass, or like the brown plastic you get on some actual things. Control R, I'm just going to split that up just to make it more defined. Control R, scale it down slightly maybe by pressing the S key, just get a bit of shape. There you have it. Hope that answered your question. That's the way I simply make a model. I've given that three textures, and I've assigned them to the three textures. One's white, one was the actual label itself, and one were a brown plasticky glass. Nice and simple. Thanks very much for watching. Please subscribe.